stuff. Who doesn't love it?
Anyone heard the story of Ebenezer Scrooge?
No.
Yes.
No.
completely understood, or else nothing wonderful can come from the story we are about to relate. Dead for 7 years, and Scrooge never painted his name off the door.
Oh, but here's a tight fit and handsome grindstone. Scrooge, I squeeze it, wrenching, grasping, scraping, clutching all the sinner. Hard and sharp as flint, from which no steel ever struck a generous fire.
The clocks have struck three the day before Christmas Eve. Though it was already dark in Scrooge's cold counting house, where his clerk Cratchit tried in vain to warm his chilled hands.
Merry Christmas, Uncle! Bah! Christmas a humbug, you surely don't mean that. What right do you have to be merry? You're poor enough.
And what right do you to be cross? You're rich enough.
Bah!
Uncle, don't be cross.
What else can I be? What's Christmas to you but paying bills with no money? A time for finding yourself a year older, but not a dime richer. If I work my wit, every fool who goes around shouting Merry Christmas would be boiled in their own Christmas pudding and buried with a stake of holly through their heart.
Uncle!
Nephew! You keep Christmas in your way, and I will keep it in mine.
But you'll keep it. There are many things I have profited from that haven't put a coin in my pocket, and I say they've done me good. Here, here!
One more word out of you, Cratchit, and you will be celebrating Christmas by losing your position.
Uncle, we have never had a quarrel I have been a party to. So please, join us for Christmas lunch. Will you come?
Ah!
Merry Christmas to you, Mom.
Merry Christmas to you, sir, to the lady.
Scrooge and Molly, I believe. Do I have the pleasure of addressing you, Mrs. Scrooge and Mrs. Molly?
Marley has been dead these 7 years.
We have no doubt his liberality is well represented by the surviving partner.
At this time of year, it's highly desirable to make some slight provisions for the poor and destitute who greatly suffer at this time of year. Many thousands are in want of all necessary.
Are there no prisons?
Yes, sir.
No workhouses?
Yes, sir. I'm afraid so.
I was afraid that they were closed and no longer served their useful operations.
Many would rather die than go there.
Then let them do so and decrease the surplus population.
So, should I put you down here?
Nothing.
You wish to be anonymous?
I wish to be left alone. I support these organizations through taxes, which those I can already barely afford. I say good day to you.
But sir!
I said good day. I suppose you will be wanting the whole day off tomorrow.
It's convenient, sir.
It is not. It is not convenient to pick a man's pocket every 25th of December. But I'm sure you would find yourself ill-used. Be here all the earlier the next morning.
Yes, sir. I will, sir. And Merry Christmas, sir.
This day was Christmas Eve, and Scrooge, not wanting any part of the holiday, conducted his business as usual. Others may celebrate this holiday, but stingy old misers never take a day off.
He doesn't look happy at all.
Scrooge was not collecting smiles, only money.
Ah, that is £4.10 you owe me. That is your business, madame, not mine.
But it's for the children, sir.
Nevertheless, you owe me £4.10.
If we could have 2 more weeks.
In 2 more weeks, it'll be £5.02.
But we barely need that to eat. You'll starve.
Sign here.
Confiscate
your store, as is my right.
You have no
more time but give me nothing? Well, then I'll have it tomorrow.
But tomorrow is Christmas Day.
Second. Party! On behalf of many people you've made happy. Now be quiet and do as I say, and you'll have a Merry Christmas.
Yes, dear.
Of all the years and all the days that I'm familiar with, there's only one that's such as one.
December the 25th!
Ask anyone they promise to you about a change of foot. Their favorite day, and they will say,
December the 25th! December the 25th! My year, December the 25th! The dearest day.
Yeah.
back.
Happy Christmas again.
Happy Christmas, everybody.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
I'm supposed to
It seems the wife has strong feelings for you. Look, now is the time. Why should you care? Are there no workhouses? Are there no prisons? If not, then let them die and decrease the surplus population.
That is unfair, Spirit. Will the boy live?
I see a tiny empty chair in the corner. None of my brothers or sisters will see him at another Christmas.
There must be something we can do.
Maybe we should boil him in his own Christmas pudding.
Don't mock me, Spirit.
Don't worry about just them, Ebenezer. There are plenty of others who don't like you either.
Scrooge had never been to his nephew's house, even though he had been invited year after year.
Scrooge would find out this Christmas what his nephew really thought about him.
Thankful heart.
true.
Can you believe it?
It's true. It's true.
Speak up!
shall survive within me, Scrooge later proclaimed, and it was said that he was true to his word. For like many of us, Scrooge forgot that the Christmas spirit lies within us all. He would later remember this when he woke up the next morning.
I can't believe it! This spirit! They did it all in one night! I don't know what to do! A Merry Christmas to all! Hey, you boy!
Who, me, sir?
Yes, you boy! What a smart boy! What day is it?
It's Christmas Day!
What a delightful boy! I think I'm going to like children! Is the large goose still hung in the butcher shop? The next cheap one?
This is the one I am.
That's the one! Wake up the butcher and buy it! Here is half a crown! Tell him to deliver it to the Cratchit House!
Yes, yes, yes.
Now what you do? I have to get dressed! I've been invited to Christmas lunch of my nephews! It's true, it's true! It truly is a Merry Christmas!
Scrooge was true to his word. He did it all and infinitely more. And to Tiny Tim, who did not die, he was like a second father. He was as good as a friend, as good as a master, as the good old city knew.
Some people laughed to see the alteration in him, but he let them laugh. He had no further conversations with the spirits, and it was always said of him that he knew how to keep Christmas well.
May that truly be said of all of us, as Tiny Tim observed.
God bless us, everyone.
For someone who is alone as long as they have love in their hearts.
Merry Christmas, everyone!